Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the BGP origin attribute. Now, this attribute is also known as the origin type or origin code attribute, and it says that the route with the lowest origin code is preferred. Now, just a note here, this attribute is not to be confused with the originate or the self-origination attribute, which is something different. I have a video about the originate attribute as well, and you can find a link to that one in the description below. The BGP origin code is the fifth BGP attribute to be examined in the BGP best path algorithm. Let's take a look at this network here. Here we have a BGP router in AS100 that learns about the 30.30.30.0/24 network via BGP. Now, assuming that all BGP settings are set to their defaults, let's go through each of the attributes from the beginning until we get to the origin code attribute to see how it works. Now, looking at the routing table of our BGP router, we can see two entries for our destination network. We can see that the weight and local preference attributes for both routes are the same, so we go on to the next attributes. We can also see that neither route is originated by the local router, so the originate attribute does not apply here. We can also see that the AS path is the same for both routes, since the path length is identical. The next attribute to check is the origin code attribute, which is our tiebreaker in this particular scenario. Now, here we see that the path via R2 is preferred. And we know this by the greater than sign that appears beside that route. But why is this one chosen? Well, take a look at the character at the very end of the entry. For the entry coming from R1, which is the one that shows a next hop of 1.1.1.1, we have a question mark. While at the end of the entry coming from R2, which has a next hop of 2.2.2.2, we have an I. These characters we see here are the origin codes of each route. Now, on Cisco routers, this is a bit of a strange thing. There's no column header for the origin code. It's just a character that's added at the very end of the entry. Now, we can see here that the entry from R2 was chosen because of that I origin code, while the entry from R1 has a question mark. The code of I is considered a lower or better origin code, and that's why it's selected as the best path. Now that we know why this particular path was chosen, let's take a look at the origin codes themselves and what they mean. An origin code essentially tells BGP how that particular routing entry entered the BGP domain, or in other words, what its origin is. The legend of the BGP table tells us that there are three origin codes, and we can see them here. There's I, which is IGP, E, which is EGP, and question mark, which indicates incomplete. Let's take a look at these in more detail. The I code stands for IGP, or Interior Gateway Protocol. This code indicates that the route was originated from an IGP, such as OSPF or EIGRP. However, the name is a little bit counterintuitive because what it actually means practically is that on a Cisco router, this particular route entered the BGP domain using the network command. Someone somewhere on some BGP router gave the command network 30.30.30.30 mask 255.255.255.0. Essentially, it means that the route originated from within the local routing domain of that particular router. Now, the E code stands for Exterior Gateway Protocol, or EGP. Now, this is a historical value that indicates that the route was learned using the EGP protocol. However, EGP is actually BGP's predecessor, and it's no longer in use. So ideally, you should never ever see this origin code in any modern networks. And finally, we have the question mark, which indicates incomplete. This value shows that the route's origin is unknown or is simply not specified. And we commonly see this when routes are redistributed into BGP from other routing protocols or from static routes. So this means that the redistribution command may have been used to inject this particular route into the BGP domain. So when a BGP router advertises a route to its peers, it indicates the origin attribute to provide context on how the route was learned or what its origin is. Now, the origin code is a mandatory non-transient attribute, meaning it must be present in all BGP route updates and it must not be changed as the route is advertised from BGP router to BGP router and from AS to AS. Now let's go back to our diagram to see how these two entries got different origin codes. We see here that routers R3 and R4 are directly connected to the 30.30.30.0/24 network. Now let's see how R3 has injected this network into its BGP domain. We can see here that the network command was used to put this network in the BGP table. So R3 is the source of the route to 30.30.30.0 with the IGP origin. Let's now see how R4 is configured. Here we see that R4 has the redistribute connected command in the BGP configuration. This means that all connected networks are redistributed into BGP. And we can see here that the 30.30.30.0 network is a directly connected network to R4. So R4 is the source of the route to 30.30.30.0 with the incomplete origin. And in this final diagram, we can see how these two BGP advertisements of this particular destination were originated by routers R3 and R4, and how both of these reached our BGP router in AS100. R3 sent the route with the I origin code, and R4 sent the route with the question mark origin code. And because that origin code attribute is mandatory and non-transient, it means that it remains unchanged throughout its whole traversal of the network. So that's the origin code or origin type attribute and how it's used within the BGP best path algorithm. Well, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.